Hey, it's Fran, again. The video about the progress that I've been making in using the Shaper Origin handheld CNC router, this time with a project that I've been working on for several months. It's a clock, and I decided to use the Shaper Origin to make the case, the enclosure for the clock, and it's actually even been interesting integrating Shaper milled wood parts with 3D printed parts. The actual clock display is 3D printed, and it was very interesting to interface that with plywood using the Shaper Origin, derived from my CAD files that I used to create both the case and the 3D printed parts for the display. Here, the 3D printed display is set into a recess that I've milled out in 3/4 inch plywood with the shaper. It's not sitting on top of it, it's actually recessed in a very tight fit. I'm milling the clock case in sections, and these sections will all be glued together and laminated into two different solid pieces that will then be bolted together with two bolts. It's coming together. The pieces have to be glued yet, and they have to be sanded. There's some finish sanding that I'll have to do before I put a finish on it. But you can sort of see the general idea of the clock case coming together. I chose the hardware that I was going to use for the clock out of the new old stock switches that I got from the U-Pen haul last year. These are Switchcraft switches, really beautiful, and not only have the right aesthetic, but they have just the right feel for this clock. I created all of the files in AutoCAD and then had to convert the files from the DWG AutoCAD format into SVG, scaled vector graphics files that the Shaper Origin can understand and use. And I did that conversion in Adobe Illustrator. Here's the original artwork for the back of the clock. I created it out of a combination of hand-drawn pencil art and artwork that I rendered in Photoshop, put it into Adobe Illustrator, and converted the whole thing into a vector file, and then did the necessary fills for solid shapes and such to create a type of SVG file that the Shaper Origin can understand and work around so that I can control exactly where the router is routing the lines, either internal or external. It was a complicated process to get used to interpreting how the shaper would want to view a file to be able to make a cut from it. So here I'm going to cut the backing piece for the clock out of a piece of 1/4 inch thick birch plywood. And I've created the workspace with the tracking tiles and such in advance. First thing I've got to do is mill out a recess for a pair of washers that are going to be used to hold the bolts that I'm going to use. You can see it milled out a perfect fit, nice and flush. You can completely adjust the depth of each cut as well as the tolerance to the guidelines, so with some practice you can get very accurate mills, milling out recesses for parts that you need to insert. Here I'm doing a roughing cut around the outside. First cut is done 30 mils outside of the actual line for the rough cut, and then I'll go back in after cleaning the work surface. I'll set the tolerance to cut on line and then do the final cut for the outside. So here I've switched to an engraving bit, and I'm going to engrave the lettering. Set the depth for just 8 mils. And using the shaper's auto-routing function, which is very handy with doing small details, you just put the, as long as it'll fit in the guide circle, just put the entire letter in the guide circle, hit the auto-route function, and it'll complete the entire letter in one shot. When I'm using the auto-router function, I'm not actually moving the shaper at all. I'm just holding the shaper in one spot over top of the letter. Hitting the start, it plunges the bit, auto-routes the entire letter, and then I just retract the bit, move to the next letter, and repeat. When I'm using the auto-routing function, the detail is actually quite high, and you can adjust the speed at which it'll actually do all this routing depending on the material and the kind of detail that you want. You can slow it down, so you have total control over the speed of the plunge and also the speed of the actual routing itself, so no worries about having complete control to get the best detail out of the material that you happen to be milling out. Now I use two different techniques for doing the engraving. For the larger pieces, I'm just using a single line around the outside, and because these letters are much larger, I'm having to do a combination of manual pushing the router, and then when I get to a detailed part of a letter, I'll hit the auto button, and it'll the shaper will just auto-route around those details, and then I'll move to the next section and then auto-route that. So larger characters, larger letters, you can use a combination of auto and manual, moving the shaper around, doing the outside and inside of the letters. The shaper keeps track of where it's cut, so when you have a letter like this where you have to cut one cut around the outside and then there are internal cuts, the shaper has some intelligence, so it remembers where you've cut, and so when you go to cut the next line, it will assume that you want to cut the line that's on the interior. Even though they might be right next to each other, it just chooses the other line for you to cut on. So yeah, there is some intuition in how it selects the line that it's cutting, and also, you'll notice that I'm cutting in a particular direction because the shaper, it chooses a path, either clockwise or counterclockwise around the item that you're milling. And you will follow the dotted line in the direction that the line is moving. So it will tell you, I want you to follow this character counterclockwise or clockwise, depending on whether it's an inside-outside or whatever. It does make judgments on that. Even though it's a router and it's spinning in one direction, it does work in both directions depending on the bit that you're choosing. And again, just some final details on the B. And the same technique of moving the shaper, moving the guide circle, using the auto, and then again choosing the tolerances for what you want to cut inside, outside. I found that a toothbrush is a handy tool when you're doing engraving or small cuts. Just run the toothbrush in there, it gets all the little gravelly bits out of the engraving. The final part was milling out my signature, and this was very interesting because this is actually from an actual pencil drawing that I rendered in an SVG file to scale, so it is at my actual scaled signature that I'm able to route out with the origin to scale, and I was very happy with the way that turned out. Alright, well that's it for this one. I'll post some updates on this clock project as I get it together and finish up the case. I'm Fran. I'll see you soon. Bye.